Hi my dear friends, today topic is SAP SD Customer Master. Means here we discuss how to create the customer, how to change the customer, how to display the customer, even how to block the customer, different scenarios we can analyze here. First of all, I will explain you one thing, how to create the customer. And where I want to create the customer, T code is XD01. Do one thing, I will tell you one thing here. What is the difference between T code XD01 and FD01? See this one, even this XD01 also create the customer. Even this FD01 also create the customer. Okay, and what is the difference between XD01 and FD01? Concentrate here. And this XD01 means whatever customer you are creating under XD01, that customer used for the sales and distribution purpose. Okay. And whatever customer you are creating under FD01, that customer used for the finance people, accounts receivable purpose, AR, accounts receivable. And this is SD purpose. This is SD. Okay, see this one. This XD01, whatever customer you are creating in the XD01, that is SD purpose. And whatever customer you are creating in FD01, that is called AR, accounts receivable purpose, who are in the finance people, and that one used for the finance purpose. Even under this description I will give accounts receivable link. You just watch and understand how to create the accounts receivable. Let us go to FD01 first in the SAP. Yeah, go to FD01, enter. See this one, there accounts group and customer and company code. Okay, we have only these three things. Let us take screenshot here for your understanding purpose. I will explain you. Yeah, let's take screenshot and open Word. Yeah, paste it here and go to XD01, enter. See this one, and there is accounts group, customer and company code. There are the sales area data and sales organization, distribution channel and division. Let us take screenshot of this also. Yeah. Now you just analyze both screens. This is called FD01, only accounts group, customer and company code and reference. But when I go to here, they are maintained sales area data, sales organization, distribution channel and division. Okay, so whatever the customer you created into the XD01, that is for SD purpose, sales and distribution purpose. Whatever customer you are creating FD01, that is called AR purpose, accounts receivable. Okay, so let us create the customer in the account sales and distribution purpose and understand. Yeah. And go to SAP. The first one, how to create the customer master. The T code is XD01. For your understanding purpose, I am going to through path. You just understand, yeah. And SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, accounts receivable, and master records. See this one. This is the FD01. When I double click on here, create into the FD01, that is for accounts receivable purpose. And select here maintain centrally and create here whatever customer you can create into the XD01, that is for sales and distribution purpose. I will tell you one thing, when you create the customer into the FD01, later you can extend to XD01. That is the different process. I will explain you later. Now you can create the customer into the XD01. Okay. And you just double click on XD01. See this one. The first one is accounts group. My previous video, I explained accounts group and partner determination. So what is meant by accounts group? Accounts group nothing but to classify the customer. Accounts group, let it be, for example, here I can create different accounts group. See this one. MR domestic customer, MR foreign customer, MR inventory customer group, and service related customer group. Means whatever you are creating the customer, that customer belongs to which area. For example, he is domestic, or he is a foreigner, or he is regarding to the inventory, or he is regarding to the service oriented customer. That customer belongs to, I mean, which related, which group. Okay, for example, my customer is belongs to accounts group, and enter here company code, and example, enter MR01. My company code is MR01. Later you can enter sales organization and distribution channel and division. So what is meant by sales organization, what is meant by distribution channel, what is meant by division? These things I explained into the organizational structure. So you just watch my second video of SD. Okay, my previous classes you just watch. So now I need to take sales organization. These three things I created at the time of organization structure creation. Okay, and you just watch previous videos. So here I am directly selecting what is mean, like see this one, MR sales organization, and select here distribution channel, nothing but this customer belongs to wholesale or retail. We have distribution channel process. So there I explained into the organization structure. You just watch that video. And here I need to select wholesale, MR wholesale, and division, this let division like M1 bikes. Okay, bikes, cars, different divisions. Okay, so select here accounts group, and don't enter anything into the customer column. Why? Because this customer number picks automatically. Why it is picks automatically? It means at the time of number range configuration, I mean direct the system, this number range picks automatically. I will show you why it is picks automatically. Click on here. Okay, I will show you why it is picks automatically. Means I will explain you later. Yeah, and see this one, the customer, it's entered in the internal. Why? Means the number picks automatically. Why it is picks automatically? And click on your new window. I will explain you. click on your new window. I will show you the path. SPRO, enter. SAP reference IMG. And select here, example financial accounting new, and accounts receivable and payable and customer accounts, master data and preparation for creating customer master data. See this one. In the first one, I need to define accounts group with the screen layout. And here, see this one, create number range for customer accounts. You just double click on here. And let us see the display. For example, see this one and go down. See, this is the number range I created for the MC, MF, like MS, this is the number ranges I created for the my customer group. See this one, whenever you selected this radio button, I already created, you just watch my previous video, you can understand. Once again, I'm explaining. Okay. Whenever you selected this radio button, it means you need to manually enter the customer number range from this number to this number. Any number from this interval, you need to enter manually. When you don't select this radio button, it means the number picks automatically from this interval. Like this is the scenario. Here I need to create the customer number ranges. When you want to create, click on your intervals, then click on your add, then create. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. So this is the interval. Now you can enter customer name. For example, before entering the customer name, enter the title. This customer regarding to company or miss, mister, what is this? This is the professional. For example, my customer belongs to company. So what is meant by this tick mark? Here showing that some tick mark. See this one? The country is, it's showing one tick mark. Tick mark means this is required field. This is required field. Which field not showing to the tick mark, that is called optional field. What is meant by optional? For example, here it is showing tick mark and here it is not showing to the tick mark. When it is showing not tick mark, like right mark, when you enter the information or when you don't want to enter the information, this is your requirement. If you enter or not enter, your concern. But when it is showing tick mark, you must enter the information in the this field. Okay. And do one thing. Here my question is, how to control the customer master data fields? How to control the customer master data fields? Do one thing. Go to another screen. See this one. Define accounts group with the screen layout. You just double click on this. And go to your customer groups. See this one. Now I am creating MR domestic customer. So you just click on here, display. And see this one. This is the fields. This is the fields. For example, you just double click on general data and double click on address, all the tabs address tab, communication tab, control tab, all the tabs. For example, when I double click on address tab, see this one, this is the name, this is the name, and this is the street, this is the regional. All the fields is available at the time of customer creation. For example, I am control surplus and required, optional and display. Okay, now all are the optional. For example, now I am doing, this is the required, and search term also required. Then click on here save and save. So what happened here, go to customer and go back, close this. Again you can enter accounts group and company code and organization and all, then click on here OK. Let us see here, now this is name and search term is required. Why? Because here I did this is the required. Okay, and what is meant by required? When I click on here required, it means at the time of customer creation you must enter the data. So when I click on here optional, you may enter the data, you may not enter the data. And when I click on here display, when I click on here display, the field is displayed but I am unable to enter any data. Okay, and when I click on your suppress, even that field, for example this search term field, not, for example when I click on your search stream as a suppress and click on your save and go to customer master data, this is a search stream, right? And go back, example close this, again enter the all the information, then click on here OK. Let us see, there is a no such stream field. Why? Because at the time of accounts group fields, I click on here suppress. Now you just click on here required, optional and display. Example, click on here display and save and go back, again enter the all the information, then click on here OK. See this one, now the field is displayed but I am unable to enter any information. Okay, then double click on general data and address. Now click on here optional or required. Example, I am click on here optional and save and go there and remove this and enter all the information again, then click on here OK. Now see this one, now I am able to enter the information. So what need to understand here, at the time of accounts group and screen layout, that screen layout is control the fields at the time of customer creation, okay. Now you select here, this is the company and my customer name is VSVR Private Limited, and this is the such stream. What is meant by such stream? This is the unique name for identification of particular customer. Okay, and enter here VSVR, then enter the address, complete address you need to enter. Example, Amirpet, house number 6655, postal code 500016, house Hyderabad, country India, and click on your region 01 means Andhra Pradesh. Then go down. In case if you want to enter post box number, example 500016, and postal code also 500016. And in case if you want to enter, customer telephonic number, mobile number, fax number, like all the information, communication, other communication, if you want to enter, you can enter. Otherwise, you can leave blank. Okay. And the practice purpose, you must enter. And see this one. This control data and payment transaction, control data and payment transaction, deal with the F5 people. These two tabs not work out the SD people. For example, vendor as a customer, payment term, these two tabs deal with the FICO people. The SD people do the marketing. And what is mean by Nelson ID? What is mean by Nelson ID? For example, Nelson ID means the do one thing. Nelson is the company. Nelson is the company. What they will do? They will, before starting any company, the Nelson is a do the survey of different areas. For example, I want to start one institute. And where I want to start, and means in the institute, which course is suitable for me. So that things this Nelson company verified. This Nelson company like do the survey, which is the suitable place for established institute. Not only institute, any company. This is the surveyor company. Okay, and that survey company, they will give someone ID. Okay. And here you need to assign that ID, means this particular customer belongs to which region under the survey. So how to create this Nelson ID, how to create that? See this one here, I can enter the path SPRO, sales and distribution, master data, business partner, customer, marketing, and Nelson ID. Okay, and do one thing and create one Nelson ID. What is that? How to create a Nelson ID? SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG, select here sales and distribution, and enter here master data, business partner, and customers, marketing. See this one, define Nelson ID. Here we are creating regions under the survey of Nelson. Not only Nelson, different surveys companies there, you can approach any company. Okay, and you just double click on here. And see this one, click on your new entry, enter your any two digit, example, and N1 Andhra Pradesh AP region. Enter and save and back. See this one. This is the N1 Andhra Pradesh region, and click on your new entry, enter any two digit, write the description, and go to customer. See this one, Nelson ID. So like that you need to create Nelson ID. Click on your new entry. See this one, AP region, one for region 1, region 2, and AP region, like that you can create any region. Okay, for example, I am taking N1. And customer class, what is mean by customer class? Customer class nothing but do one thing. See here, when I create this customer belongs to under which which turnover. This is the between 0.5 to 1.5 million turnovers, and this belongs to up to 0.5 million turnovers. This is belongs to which turnover? This is belongs to, this customer deal with the business per year, how much crores or how many lakhs up to 0.5 millions and 0.5 to 1.5 millions. This is the customer, the per year, how much the do the turnover. Okay, for example, I am doing up to 0.5 millions. Here you need to specify the turnovers. Okay, and this is the customer belongs to which, I mean how much turnover he can able to reach. And industry, this is the customer belongs to which industry. For example, here different industries is there, like airline industry, and see this one, chemical industry, and different industry, electronical industry, and other industries, oil industry, whatever customer VSVR Private Limited belongs to which industry. Okay, and see this one, here I can enter customer classification and create industry. Okay, do one thing, go back here, same path. For example, see this one here, define customer classification and define industry section code. And for example, when you want to create the industries, you just click on your new entry. Not here, see customer classification. For example, here different classification belongs to which turnover, and see this one, define industry sector for the customer. See, there is a lot of industries is there. If you want to create new industry, very simple, click on your new entry, enter here any 4 digit, write the description. Okay, and now I don't want, if you want to create, you can create and go back, go to customer master. Example, I'm selecting, this is electronical industry. This is electronic industry. Okay, and then go to uploading points. Go to uploading points. What is meant by uploading points? Uploading points means here we need to assign the calendar. Here we need to assign the calendar. This is customer follows which calendar? See this one, German standard calendar or factory calendar. Which calendar they are following, and see this one, for example, here you can select standard calendar 01 factory calendar. Okay, and for example, uploading means some companies are receiving the goods for particular time. For example, my office in Hyderabad, and all the lorries and trucks not allowed daytime, within the cities. So when the government of Telangana, when they are allowed into the lorries and trucks into the city only for night time, it means goods I am unable to receive the daytime, I am only receive the goods in night time. Okay, goods receive when means when this enter here any 4 digit, MR uploading, MR unloading point means what time you are receiving your goods. Some people, they are not receiving the weekend time, they are receiving the goods only weekdays, they are not receiving the weekends. So that information you need to specify that. For example, Monday or morning time or afternoon time, what time you are receive, and Tuesday what time you are receive, and Wednesday what time you receive. For example, when I click on this, and what time, hours, minute and seconds. Then for example, I am receiving 12 o'clock and 13 minutes, this the seconds. Then click on here, OK. See this one, this time in the Monday, this time to like Monday I receive the goods this time to this time, and Tuesday what time to what time, and Wednesday what time to what time. If you receive the goods even Saturday and Sunday, you can set the time. Means when the customer, what time they are receiving the goods of particular the customer. Okay, if you want to enter any information, you can enter, otherwise click on here, okay. For example, for your understanding purpose, I can enter only Monday, then click on here, okay. See this one, then click on here, export data. Very simple. Unloading points means the customer, what time he received the material, okay, that is you want to enter. When you click on your goods receive hours, then set the time, okay, and click on here, export data, and here here it can be shows for the time and by cart. For example, see this one, see country, and is this, I mean this customer belongs to which country, Brazil, Burma or India. Like let us see here, see this one, India. Like in case you want to enter export data, if you, this customer is belongs to foreigner, so you need to enter this data, okay. Then contact person, in this VSVR company whom to contact. For example, see, I want to, in this customer place, this is the company, this is the company, under that company whom to contact. For example, I want to contact Mr. Ravi, and first name is Punnam, and he is belongs to which department, he is sales department, he is the finance department. Like let us select here, see this one, production department, sales department, sales department, okay. And under this VSVR company private limited, from whom I want to contact, what is the first name and what is the last name, he is belongs to which department, okay. And see this one, this is the address and marketing and upload and export and contact. And here this company code data and sales area data. The company code data take care of FI people, especially FI people. Even this company code creation deal with the FI people. That, I mean, how to deal with that, I can give the description link, you just watch, okay. Even AR configuration I will give you in the description column, you just watch and that video. You, for example, you just double click on company code data and reconciliation account, this is domestic customer. And what is mean by short key, what is mean by short key, short key is the screen layout of assignment field. What is mean, where it is assignment field, assignment field at the time of accounting entry posting, okay. At the time of accounting entry posting, there is a assignment field, that field screen layout is short key. Basically this is deal with the like a FI people. For your understanding, you just let us see, even this payment transactions and payment term, immediate payment and correspondence, and an insurance and withholding tax, all are taken care by FI people, okay. But this is the mandatory reconciliation account and short key, that is the reason I assigned. Now you just click on your sales area data. This sales area data purely take care of SD people, okay. Now what is your sales office, this sales office I explained at the time of enterprise structure, you just watch my previous videos. and click on your sales office. See this one, MR sales office and sales group, like us, MR sales group and customer group. See this one, like this is belongs to again which group. For example, see this one, like customer incomplete group, and like different groups is available, like see, development partner, trading company, industrial group, like this customer belongs to which group. Okay, so this is the optional. If you want to select, otherwise you just keep it as it. And this is the pricing. We have in-depth pricing procedure and pricings. I will explain you next classes, but here you can select for understanding pricing group. See this one, do one thing. The pricing group means bulk buyer, occasional buyer, new customer. Do one thing, I will tell you one thing. Excel, open Excel. I will explain you one thing here. For example, I am the business, and this is the bulk buyers, and this is occasional buyers, and this is new buyers. What happened? For example, my product cost 100 rupees. But this products, whoever purchase in the bulk, whoever's at the time of this product for the bulk, I can give only 90 rupees. And occasional customers, I can give 80 rupees. And the new customer, I can give, for example, bulk product, obviously I can decrease my price. So bulk customer 90 rupees, and occasional customer I will do 95 rupees, and new customer obviously I can give normal MRP 100 rupees. And this is the price, and this is the group, pricing group, bulk, occasional and new customer. So based on this, at the time of accounting entry posting, this price will be picked. Basically this is the very big concept pricing. I will tell you later. Okay, and example bulk buyer and pricing. See this one, like a standard, you just select standard. I will tell you later why it is standard and how it is standard. Select the standard and pricing list. See this one, wholesale, retailer and industry, public sector, like example wholesaler. Okay, and see this one, exchange rate is the M is the standard one, average rate. Okay, and then click on your shipping and delivery priority. Click on your delivery priority, high priority, normal priority and low priority. For example, I have three customers. One customer is high priority, and second customer is medium priority, and third customer is low priority. Okay, and this customer, whenever he asks the material, first I can send the material high priority customer, later I can do medium priority customer, later I will do lower priority customer. do one thing. I will tell you one thing. Example, I have two customers. I have the products. I have products 45 quantity. Now high priority customer asking 45 quantity products, and medium priority customer also asking 45 quantity products. I don't have like 90 products. I have only 45 quantity. I have only quantity 45. So which customer, I mean my material sent to whom, I can cancel the medium. I can cancel the medium customer. These products I can send to high priority customer. Okay, so based on this you can select this is the customer belongs to whom. Example, high priority. And enter the plant. This is the customer belongs to which plant. Basically do one thing, when you enter the plant here, either you can enter the plant at the time of material creation, or either you can enter the plant at the time of customer creation. When you not maintain at the time of customer creation or at the time of material creation, it throw out the error message. Okay, and so you can, in case if you want to enter, enter, otherwise you can create, I mean you can enter at the time of material creation. And click on your billing. Yeah, see this one, like here terms of payment, immediate payment, example, and credit control area. And this credit controlling area, purely this terms of payment, credit controlling area, purely take care by FI people. Okay, then in contents, example, let us take cost and freight. Then click on your partner determination. This partner determination picks automatically. If you want to understand partner determination, you just watch my previous video. Okay, then click on your save. So it's going on browse. Yeah, see this one, the customer 7300010 has been created. This is the company code and sales organization, like sales organization, distribution channel and division. Okay, the later, for example, one more customer I can create for your understanding purpose. Click on here XT01, enter your accounts group, company code and sales organization, distribution channel and division. Then click on your OK and enter your, select your company, enter the customer name, example, like AS and Co, and enter your search stream, ASCO, address SR Nagar, 8888 house number, and post box number 53016, Hyderabad, country India, 01 is Andhra Pradesh. For your understanding purpose, once again I am creating. this is the post box number and postal code. If you want to enter the information, you can enter all the contact details. Then click on your marketing. These two tabs take care by finance people. Click on your marketing. Select here Nelson ID. Okay, example 01. Select here customer class. Example, this is belongs to up to 0.5 turnover, millions of turnover, and industry, and this is belongs to building industry or commercial industry, agriculture industry. You can select anything, okay, and building electronic industry, and yeah, click on your upload and enter here any name, MR uploading points. If you click on here, assign the calendar 01 standard calendar, receiving hours Monday, Tuesday, what time? Example Monday 12 to, this is the hours and this is the minutes. From this time to this time only I can receive the goods. From this time to this time, click on here, enter. Only I can receive the goods on Monday. Then export data. Okay, what is the country and what the all the information. Then contact person. And here I can enter Mr. Somu. Somu, and first name is Ramu. Name is the Somu, first name is Ramu. Age, the department belongs to sales department. Okay, press enter and save. Okay, don't save and go to click on your company code data. Select here Recon account and short key, then click this company code data take care by like F5 people. Payment transaction, terms of payment 0001, immediate payment. Then click on here sales area data and here enter sales office and sales group and customer group. Then press enter. Say MR sales office, sales group, and private customer. Okay, if you want to enter, and shipping, what is the priority? High priority. If you want to enter, I mean, shipping condition means how you are transport the material, like as soon as possible, standard, and which time. For example, as soon as possible, then billing. Like yeah, select here cost and freight 0001, immediate partner determination picks automatically, then click on here save. See this one, the customer 7300001 is created. Then so this is completed. Next, display customer master data. Display customer master data XD01. Display customer master data. Before going to display, better you can change customer master data. XD02. No, already XT02 is there. This is completed. This is not completed. Change customer master data. Okay, and how, for example, which customer I need to change? I created two customers, example yes and co. I need to change any field, and you just double click on here enter your customer number, company code, sales organization and distribution channel and division, then click on your OK. See this one, which area I need to change. For example, I am going to general, like I am changing, this is not Andco, this is private limited. I am changing the name, private limited. So AS, like PL, I am changing the name and search from, then click on here save. See, changes has been made it. Now this is also done. Now see this one, display changes customer master XT01. Before going to that, display changes, what is that? XT04, display changes. What I created, I changed the name and search term. So this, double click on display changes and enter customer data and company code MR01 and obviously sales organization, distribution channel, blah blah XYZ, then press enter and click on your all changes. See this one, I changed name and name to search term. This is the old one, AS and Co. The new one, AS Private Limited. So this is the display changes. Okay. And when you double click on any line item, it will show what time they changed, which user changed, what changed, entire information it shows. Okay. Then, and display the customer. Means here only display. It is not changes. FD03, you just double click on FD03, display, enter your customer and company code, sales organization, distribution channel, division. This is the just for the display. I am unable to edit anything. Okay, just for display. Then and how to block the customer. XD05, double click on XD05, enter here which customer you need to block, what is the company code, what is the sales organization. Okay, then press enter. See this one, posting blocks. For example, sometime this company code belongs to, I mean this customer belongs to all the company codes. So I need to block for all the company codes or specific company codes, whatever. So I am blocking all the company codes or selecting company code. What is meant by selected company codes? This is the customer blocked only this company code. And this customer works all the company codes except this company. So when I click on all the company codes, this customer unable to work in your company. Like example, I mean order block, delivery block, billing block, like different blocks is there. When I click on all sales area block, only billing block, like then click on your details. See this one, like calculation missing, why you are blocking this customer, pricing incomplete, like check debit memo. This is the optional actually. Okay, but I am blocking all the areas, all the company codes, then save. Then how to unblock the customer? Same thing, go to XD05, press enter, remove this tick mark means unblock, then save. So yes, changes has been saved. So thank you very much. If you like this video, please subscribe and share and comment if you have any doubts. Thank you very much.